What's up, people of the internet? Mike Dawg Digital here, and today I'm going to show you how to adjust your tracking, kerning, and leading in Photoshop. First things first, you're going to need the character panel. You may not have it. If you don't have it, you simply go to Window and select Character. And when you do that, it'll probably appear like this. And I like to just drag it over here. So first, let's start with tracking. I'm just going to type in my YouTube name. Okay, so here it is, with no tracking, kerning, or leading adjusted. As you can see over here in the character panel, the leading is right here. This is auto. The tracking is zero, and the kerning is metrics. And actually, a better option for kerning, if you're not going to kern letters, is to make it optical. This just makes it look a little better. Now, to adjust the tracking, all you do is click on tracking right here, and you can select one of these numbers, or you can type in your own number. So I'll just make it really wide and make it 200. And there you go, tracking. Now let's change the leading. Leading is right here, it's on auto right now. I'm just going to make it 72 since this type is so big. And you can also type in whatever number you would like. I'll actually make that 100. That's a little better. And finally, let's talk about kerning. I'm going to put the tracking back to zero for this. And to kern letters, you just simply click between the letters with the type tool. And then you go to your kerning. And I'm just going to make it negative 100. And that is how you adjust the tracking, leading, and kerning in Photoshop. I hope this video was helpful. Please leave a like if you enjoyed it. Leave me a comment, let me know how I did. And if you can think of anything else you would like me to show you how to do in Photoshop, just tell me, and I will try my best to make a video about it.